Download the app and turn us up. Turn us up. This is Beat 106 Scotland.
Myself and Dougal hooked up with the Radio 1 legend, keeping the rave alive, connoisseur. That's right. I'll let him talk himself. Come on then, bro.
This is Kutski and you're in tune to Joey f***ing Riot on Bonkers Beats.
Scotland.
So as we start to head into the second half of this show, things are going to get a little bit harder very soon. I'm just going to call me old buddy. It's Mick from Destructive Tendencies. Let's see if I can get him on the blower. Yo, Mick, how's it going, buddy?
Hey, Joey, good to hear your voice, mate. Sweet pal, how are you?
Yeah, rocking, man. Welcome to Beat 106 once again.
Thank you.
Yeah, cool, man. So, a pretty cool show this time. I'm doing the second half here, pretty much all Destructive Tendencies stuff. And we've been going for quite some time, haven't we? When did we start? Can you even remember? Because I've had some memories pop up on my Facebook memories from, like, Decibel, which was the first European gig. I think that was 2013, was it?
Yeah, that was 2013. So I mean, we met each other at raves like in the late 2008, 2009, and then it was 2010 when we first got in the studio. And my brother bought me for Christmas some studio time with each track. So yeah, that's when we first met. Man, 2010.
And then 3 years later, we were on stage at Decibel with the Anger Fist warming up for us. Bless him.
Yeah, man.
So yeah, we're going to talk about a bunch of stuff because we're playing a whole lot of our music here on the show tonight. I mean, sometimes we rattle on about tracks and stuff like that, and this is a track-related story, but we're going to talk about, you know, some funny stuff that's happened to us on the road, because I think this is what people want to hear, the stories of what goes on backstage and stuff. So I'm about to drop We Are Fighters, which is our collaboration with The Tweakers. Now, we've been lucky enough to play back-to-back with the guys on a few occasions, and we're going to talk about one weekend in particular. I'll let you kind of lead it off, because I'm thoroughly embarrassed by this.
Yeah, so it was a huge event. It was the weekend of Dominator, so we're over in Europe for Dominator on the Saturday, and then on the Friday it was one called Perukaville. So it's it's in Germany, and it's the biggest electronic music festival that there is there. I think like 150,000 people or something during the course.
Yeah,
so we were playing, the Tweakers had their own arena, so we were playing back-to-back there, and everybody that knows the Tweakers know that they are huge fans of music, but also huge fans of Jägermeister.
Which I am not. Can I just clarify this?
No.
I hate it, man.
Yeah, so throughout the set, you're always having shots of it, but then at one moment, was it? It was Kemp, weren't it, Joey? Or was it Marcus and Thrun? I think it was Kemp, wasn't
Kemp.
It?
Yeah, it was Kemp.
Yeah, it was Kemp. With such aggression, it was Kemp.
He's got a lot to answer for. Both have to be fair.
Kemp was on the front of the stage with Joy with a bottle of Jaeger, and then they both decided to down it straight from the bottle.
Well, can I just clarify something? Well, first of all, we had pretty much drank our rider, which was a bottle of vodka, a bottle of Jack Daniels, and several beers as well, which I don't normally drink at events. So I was already absolutely plastered. I was on the microphone, and Kemp came out and took it off me and was like, "Who wants to see Joey drink down a full bottle of Jägermeister?" And I was like, no, I just grabbed the mic off. I was like, no chance. I went from MC voice to just
like,
on Scottish, just straight, no way. And I said, I thought this was a good idea because I was steaming. I said, I'll drink half of it if Ken drinks the other half. And everybody's like, yeah. So, yeah, we downed half a bottle of Jägermeister each. That's the last thing I really remember from the set until I'll let you take over.
So yeah, I think we were closing it, so it was time to sort of go back home, and we're in the artist transfer on the way back with the guys, and Joey was sat behind me, I was in the passenger seat, and then I turned around and Joey was sort of slouched in the corner against the window like he was asleep, but then there was just sick coming out of his mouth and collecting around his armpit like a lake.
this is what I remember feeling like, you know, when you're just kind of feeling all wonky and stuff, and I'm very rarely sick, I've got quite a strong constitution for alcohol over the years, but it was just too much. And I think there was some nice food there as well, which I was munching at the artist lounge. So I can remember, like, you know, you get the heaving, and I tried to cover my mouth with my hands, and it was literally, it filled up my hands that much that it was starting to squirt through my fingers, and it was just little bits of squirt, the fluid of the sick, like hitting you in the back of the head, and you're turning around like, what's that, and then it just I couldn't contain it anymore, and it just flooded everywhere.
And then the worst bit was, you were saying then, and it was because there was so much there in your hand and coming out your mouth and sort of in the crevice of your arm. Then the window got opened, and obviously the backdraft then started flying me all around the car.
So the driver pulled over. I continued to throw up all over myself. I threw my t-shirt,
which you then left outside the hotel.
Well, I threw my t-shirt in the bin first of all, and then we got onto the hotel. But poor driver, man. Like, if he's ever listening, I'm so sorry. Do clean that up. And then in the morning we had to go to Dominator, which we got woke up. We were getting picked up, I think, about 11 o'clock in the morning because we had an early set in the surprise stage outdoors. I woke up and looked at my shoes, which were just covering sick, and I just threw them out the hotel window onto the roof. I had another pair of trainers, but those trainers, I was like, there's no way.
I thought you'd whizzed your shoes from like the elevator bit, and it landed on the glass roof of the reception.
No, it was out the hotel window, because I had my mate Neil MC Voyager with us, and then because we had to go to Dominator, and the driver came up and we were just like, can we stop for some food, because I was like so ropey, and so were you, we were both really, you know, hungover, and they were just like, no, we've not got time. We had to go straight to Dominator, straight through it, and straight onto the stage. But we, like, I think breakfast that morning was vodka and orange, if I remember right.
Yeah, it was. It was, and then to be fair, we've been bolted over that lake, so that kind of woke us up, and then we were straight onto the decks and back in the zone, so yeah. We're right back at it.
Yeah, and then on the main stage later, and that's like one of the best sets we've ever done on the main stage. The photographs are incredible.
Yeah, and then Peruka Village, now forever known as Pukaville.
Yeah, so thank you to the Tweakers for making that story happen, and cheers Mick for picking up and getting involved. Cheers mate.
I'll remind you of it annually every year.
No, you do.
Hiding away is a feeling that I know too well. Looking for change in a world that puts me right through hell. Through the night, you and I run until there's nothing left. Through the night, you and I. We can battle the dark when the evening ends. We can carry the spark when the lights start to dim. 'Cause we are fighters, fighters, fighters. We are fighters, fighters, fighters. 'Cause we are fighters. I can't take switching the pace on a road that leads me right to change. Through the night, you and I run until there's nothing left. Through the night, you and I. We can battle the dark when the evening ends. We can carry the spark when the lights start to dim. 'Cause we are fighters. Fighters, 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 'cause we are fighters.
DJs. This is Beat 106 Scotland.
DT versus DT, so many amazing memories with those guys. I love them to death. Marcus Kempf, I miss yous. Hopefully we're going to see them very, very soon.
We can carry the storm when the lights start to dim.
Here is the track that sent Destructive Tendencies on the way. We entered a remix competition for This Is Hardcore, and we remixed a track from Mad Dog called Agony on Trackstorm Records. It got an official release, and it just blew us into the stratosphere. A couple of years later, we're playing every major festival.
And get chatting with the tunes. We'll be right back.
I mean, you can hear how my productions came on over the years, and it gets better as we go further into the show, but it's still a classic, and it's still got loads of energy and still goes off when I play it. Next up is going to be the title track from Destructive Tendencies' first album. Yeah, this is DT with Slaves to the Darkness. You're at a major festival, the number one hardcore DJ in the whole world asks if you want to do a collab. What do you say? Go. Here is Angerfist and Destructive Tendencies. This is the Fortress of Solitude.
Welcome to my fortress. Welcome to my fortress. The fortress of solitude.
slaves to the darkness. We got to work with like pretty much all our heroes, which was mind blowing. And now I'm lucky enough to call them all friends. Here's probably my favourite producer on earth, which we've made quite a few tracks with now. This is Destructive Tendencies alongside The Player with MC Jeff. This is Play My Game.
Sometimes you know something's coming, but you feel it in the air, in your gut. You don't sleep at night. A voice in your head's telling you something is gonna go terribly wrong. There's nothing you can do to stop it.
Deliverance from darkness ignites the flames. Success beats the hunger that inflates my fame. I'm all incapable of greatness, don't forget the name. Give the only one winner when you play my game.
This next track coming in could be the contender for my favourite track off Destructive Tendencies' second album, Beyond the Lights. This is DT and the Melodist, We Need Justice.
Thank you.
have Mick here from Destructive Tendencies. How's it going, bro?
Yeah, sweet, mate. Good show so far, Joey. Fucking loving the beats, man.
Cheers, mate. Cheers. So, yeah, I want to talk about a very special track. It's by far the biggest track we've ever done. Sound Becomes One with Patty Razor. And we've got a really cool kind of backstory about it. Can you just tell us a bit about how Patty Razor got in touch to do this track in the first place?
Yeah, man. So, Wesley, I booked him for a few events over here. Big fan of his tunes and stuff again, like late 2000s. And then, yeah, in 2012, when we had This Is Your Moment, part of our plan to sort of get on these European stages was like, we need these Europeans to hear our music, don't we? So we gave Party Razor This Is Your Moment just over Facebook, it were. He replied saying, really cool track, man. I think I'll give this a spin. And he was at Dominator that weekend. So, yeah, and I was there. So, yeah, it was a mad moment, man, watching that track be played on the stage and the place went berserk. Yeah. Got some cool videos.
I remember you sending me the videos and I was like, holy what?
No, it was surreal, man, to go to those raves so much and then be stood there. At the time, you could go on the main stage. They had like a little fan stage at the side of it. So we're actually stood there and you could see the entire crowd going wild to it. It went nuts. So what he did with this, we obviously kept in touch since that, sent him more tracks. And then sort of late 2014, he said that, you know, he had this idea for a track that was pretty sentimental to him, but he'd never found the people to really do it with. And he loved our music and we'd forged a good friendship at that point. And he was kind of like, I've never felt the, you know, the spark and the buzz with anybody to do this idea and put it down. So to ask us to do that was pretty special at the time. And yeah, we liked the idea, didn't we? And then it was born from there.
Yeah, we loved it. I mean, that track, I've got such a bittersweet relationship with that track because making it was there was four people involved and it took probably about 2 weeks to make. I mean, we were trying to get it done to play at Masters of Hardcore. We were playing back to back with Patty Razor closing the main stage. You know, it's quite crazy to go from him playing a track and then a few years later we're on the main stage of Masters of Hardcore with him. And the track, yeah, I hated the song because I've spent so long. It was just an absolute nightmare to make. But
I remember because I was skiing in March. It was like that week before Masters and he's wrapping up an hour away skiing. So you were sending bits back and forward to check and listen to. I could smell your stress down the phone, mate. It was wild.
But the kind of icing on the cake was getting to play it there and see the reaction, because I think one of the things as a DJ, as I'm sure you'll testify to, Mick, is you can play tracks that everyone knows and they'll go crazy for it, but to play something that no one's ever heard before and to get a reaction like we did then, I mean, I'm getting goosebumps just talking about it. Like, I was out in front on the microphone and literally my legs get taken away from underneath me with the pure emotion, and I just sat down shaking my head looking at the crowd like, it was incredible, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was surreal, man. I remember at the time we were going wild, you could see everybody, but for me, that moment where you were out on front of stage and you said your legs were, for me, it was when I got back home and I could see some videos that people had done, so from the crowd's point of view, and you could see the light show and stuff that they choreographed for the track, and it was just insane to see that. I remember the skulls on the Master of Hardcore skull that's on stage, the eyes, sorry, the big lasers came out of that in the build-up as the track gets faster, and the place just went nuts. You could see silhouettes of people on shoulders, and I was like, wow, this is something special.
I mean, yeah, obviously it was the first time we played it out, and I didn't realise it was going to be such a special track for so many people. I mean, the reaction that night was mind-blowing, and like you, I was kind of stunned afterwards for a bit, you know, just sat for about 2 weeks just looking into space like, what happened there? But the thing is, like, that year it went to number one in the top 100 for hardcore tracks, and then I think the kind of onslaught afterwards of how it really touched people emotionally, I think the video kind of really ran that home. And it was the amount still get people sending pictures of, you know, the lyrics and stuff tattooed on them, which is, I've lost count. Do you know how many people have got it tattooed on them?
It's got to be getting close to 100. I've seen various different connotations of it, from lyrics to messages, and, you know, people meant like funerals and stuff, but then also weddings. So, you know, the kind of track that just gives that so much emotion, it can have so many different meanings to people that it could cross over to kind of opposite kind of events of life for people, like funerals and weddings. It was really mad getting that sort of stuff and seeing what it had meant for so many people.
Yeah, now we're getting, it's funny you say that about funerals and weddings, now we're getting back to working again. I am available for funerals, weddings and bar mitzvahs.
Hopefully it's your own.
Mick, please introduce this track for us.
No problem. Thanks for everybody for tuning in. This is Party Razor and Destructive Tendencies. Sound Becomes One.
What the hell?
open the door. Now the apprentice will hunger for more. Driven by torturous sounds from their minds, a bomb built to distort the fabric of time. The passion, the fury, to break down the walls. Convention can walk up this ancient wall. Strength all through her core, never undone.
Apprentice and master, the sound becomes one.
On Beat 106 Scotland, and this is Joey Riot in the mix.
Everybody wants to run without a reason, and nobody ever knows what's good for you.
DT and the player once again here.
Run, motherfucker, run,
clips, I've inserted into my gun, so I can take the money, never have to run.
Everybody wants to run without a reason, and nobody ever noticed what's good for you. Take a minute when you walk alone. There is nothing to control you now. Everybody runs around without a reason. Run, motherfucker, run!
say don't ever meet your heroes, well, guess what? Some of them are absolutely awesome. This guy, I've known him for years, but managed to actually get to hook up in the studio and we created this absolute monster. This is Death by Stereo, Destructive Tendencies and Evil Activities.
Pop goes America, pop goes America, pound, pound, pound.
Talked about our brand new track, the collab between Destructive Tendencies and Audio Freak called Misfits. Yeah, it was the first time we got played, and here it is again in its entirety.
Yo, this is Audio Freak, and you're tuned into the legend himself, the one that makes the dance floors quake and your mama's panties shake. It's Joey Ryan, right here on Beats 106, Scotland's Bonkers Beats Show. Don't go anywhere.
Joey Ryan exclusive.
Bumper to bumper, every day's gridlocked. I'm getting with that, staring at the work clock. The water meaning, yes, I'm a misfit. Your rat race is no face in me. I'm a misprint. Yeah, I'm a misprint. Well, I'm a misprint. Fucker, game over. Let's roll. Let's go.
Yeah. this is how we do it. Audio freak. Destructive tendencies.
Every day's gridlocked. I'm getting whiplash, staring at the word clock. The water meaning, yes, I'm a misfit. Your rat race is no face in me. I'm a misprint. Yeah, I'm a misprint. Well, I'm a misprint. I'm a misprint. Let's go! Motherfucker, game over.
Because you're a dead man, and the only sentient part of you left is this little bit of brain and the gristle on the end of my boot. Get up! Get up! Yeah! Who the fuck are you speaking to?
Not but a few minutes ago, I dropped a track called Agony, which was the remix that launched DT's career pretty much. And so we remixed that for DJ Mad Dog. Fast forward a few years and Mad Dog is remixing us, along with Unexist. This is his remix of Amino.
Wait, let's
finish the show on a high. I'm going to crank the BPMs right up to 200 BPM if you can handle it. If you're with me, hold on tight. We're coming to the last track of the show. I know 2 hours has just absolutely flown by.
This is Beat 106 Scotland.
Question for you guys: what happens when one of Rossdale's biggest artists teams up with the UK's biggest hardcore artist and then gets remixed by a Frenchcore icon? You don't know the answer? Here it is. Release the Kraken. Please look after yourselves and each other, as Jerry Springer used to say. I just realised what I'm saying. So if you're out and about over the next couple of weeks and you're out raving, this Saturday I'm at BTID Wonderland. Next Sunday, as mine is the crown, I will be at Creamfields. See you on the dance floor, my friends.
This is Joey Riot. This is Bonkers Beats on Beat 106 Scotland.